Henrietta Sussman grew up in the Boyle Heights area of East Los Angeles. At 15 years old, she contracted polio and spent a week in an iron lung until her body was able to mount a response and fight off the infection. That experience gave her a unique appreciation for the power of research and science, which she passed on to her son.
It's basically what drove me to become a scientist in the first place. My mother's love of discovery and knowledge and asking questions that hadn't been answered yet and figuring out something for the first time. You being the first person in the world to know something that nobody else knows, she said, is the biggest rush that you could have as a person. And that's what I get every day when I come in here.
Sussman leads a lab at the SDSU Heart Institute that is revolutionizing treatments for heart disease, the leading killer in the U.S. A broken bone or a torn muscle can heal itself, but until recently, it was assumed cells damaged during a heart attack or stroke could never be repaired. Now scientists have found heart cells not only regenerate, but have the capacity to heal broken hearts.
So you think about that, that while your heart's doing this, every second, while you're alive, there are cells that are slowly disappearing and new cells that are forming. And so by the time you get to be 50, half of the cells that are in your heart that are muscle cells you weren't born with, which is a totally different idea from what we were taught when I was going to school.
Armed with this finding, Sussman and his colleagues focus on helping heart cells regenerate faster and stronger.
How do you take that process, which is a relatively slow one, doesn't need to be fast because it's happening over your entire lifetime, can you compress that? Can you make that kind of repair and speed it up so that instead of it happening over the course of your lifetime, you can happen in a year?
Pearl Quijada, a PhD student in Sussman's lab, is helping answer that question.
So our idea is that if we take a stem cell, which we can isolate, and not just our lab, but lots of labs around the world can isolate these stem cells, and we injected them into the heart, that these cells can actually turn into the cells that are needed to cause the cell to, or cause the heart to pump up again.
Like Sussman, Quijada found inspiration from her family.
One of the main diseases in my family is cardiovascular disease. Both my uncles have suffered heart attacks. One of my uncle actually passed away because of a heart attack or a reoccurring heart attack. So it's sort of like in our family, it's sort of like it's a way of life.
Quijada knows her work could improve the future for her family.
I think about maybe like my younger brother or my sisters who are going to get married and they have families, and the therapies that we're developing in the lab can potentially be helping them.
Therapies are currently in clinical trials, and Sussman sees tremendous potential.
This isn't just for the cardiac tissue, that this enhancement of repair could be expanded to brain tissue, bone, and many other types of tissue which traditionally have not been known to be able to regenerate. We could enhance the regenerative potential of all of those tissues in the body.
Sussman's mom died in 2003, but her presence is still felt through his work.
My mom, all through her life and up till the end, was always trying to teach me and get me to recognize there are new ways of understanding and looking at things. She'd be pretty proud of what we've accomplished. She'd be happy that her initial desire to want to see me go into science was realized and that I've managed to be successful at creating a group of people who do the kind of work that she thought was so important. And I think she'd still be telling me that I could be doing it better if I'd listen to her.